Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Katie and we're going to get straight into it today. Rishi Sunak, the UK Prime Minister, has... I can't, you can't make this shit up. So, right, we'll start from the beginning. So, let me get this right. So, on the 7th of February, I uploaded a video regarding Rishi Sunak gambling with refugees' lives. Okay, so he agreed to a £1,000 bet with journalist Piers Morgan on Rwanda immigration. He bet £1,000 that airplanes will leave the country before the next election. We do not have a date for the next election yet. So yeah, he's literally betting on people's lives. That came out on Monday this week. Today is Thursday. Okay, so bear in mind, that came out on Monday, according to this article. And then yesterday, which was Wednesday, so Prime Minister's Questions happens every Wednesday in the Houses of Parliament. It's an absolute catastrophe. The whole, it needs to be reformed. But he made a transgender comment. I don't know what that comment was because I try to avoid Rishi Sunak because I hate him. He annoys me. He makes me angry. So I don't know what the comment was. So what happened Wednesday during Prime Minister's Questions was Sunak made some sort of transgender jibe joke, whatever it was. I don't know what it was because I avoid Rishi Sunak at all costs, and I especially avoid Prime Minister's Questions because it makes me very angry to watch all these people that I've paid a lot of money just piss about in the House of Commons. So I tend not to watch it. But it has come out that he made a transgender comment that was derogatory. Some people have said it wasn't, some people have said it definitely is. I don't know, I'm withholding judgment. But Brianna J's mother was in the gallery watching Prime Minister's Questions. If you don't know, Brianna J is a beautiful young girl who happened to be trans, who was murdered, and her killers were recently sentenced. So this brave mother, who is still grieving, was at Prime Minister's Questions. And Sunak made this transgender comment, jibe, joke, whatever it was. He is now refusing to apologise. Whether or not it was a joke, a jibe, whether it was legitimate or not, is not the issue. The issue is, you've upset this grieving mother. Apologise for upsetting the mother. That's all you have to do. It's basic human kindness. But then again, Rishi Sunak has proven he does not have any humanity. So I'm not surprised. You don't need to apologise for the comment if you think it's appropriate. I'm withholding judgment. I don't know what it was. If you stand by that, you do not have to apologise. But you did upset a grieving mother. Apologise to the mother. Dude, like, how inhuman are you? Again, we know how. And then today, Thursday, this came out, according to this, as of filming less than an hour ago, this has come out that a property tycoon who is a Tory donor has come out and said it's time for a change of government. He has praised Keir Starmer's engagement with business and he blasts years of Tory infighting. So they've lost one of their big donors, the Tory party have. And also, this is the best bit, stay there. In the UK, we are having issues with NHS dentists. We can't get into them, okay? So Sunak visited an NHS dentist as a campaign stunt, yeah? This NHS dentist is not taking on NHS patients. Seriously, Sunak Someone has organised for Sunak to go and visit an NHS dentist for some sort of campaign stunt before the election, which still hasn't been announced. And this NHS dentist is not taking on any new NHS patients. It's genius. Like, who is this person's advisor? Sunak, you need to get a new one. If an idiot like me can see, you know, that you're fucking up, you probably should get a new advisor, sweetheart. But it's just, it's only Thursday. What's he going to do tomorrow? Go and dance on the Queen's grave? Come on. But yeah, so far this week, the British Prime Minister has bet on people's lives. He refuses to apologise for upsetting a grieving mother. He has lost a major donor to his party. And he has commenced on a campaign for NHS dentistry by visiting an NHS dentist that is not taking on any more NHS patients. You can't make this shit up. If you've ever seen The Thick of It, it was a British political satire comedy, one of my absolute favourites. I thought that was fictional. Turns out it was a documentary. If you know, you know. Like, dude, can't make this shit up. But that was just an update. I had to do a video because I was going to do one about Sunak refusing to apologise to Brianna's mother for upsetting her. I thought, need to do this. This isn't cool. The dude's being a bit of a dick. And then it came out about, what, the Tory donor going over to Labour? Maybe. I don't know if he's going over to Labour. He's just quit. He's not going to fund the Tories anymore. And then this comes out about the dentist stunt. Like, dude, it's only Thursday, the 8th of February. I am convinced that the Tory party are using him as a scapegoat. I said this in my last video, where I discussed Sunak betting on the lives of refugees. I think the Tory party are going to use Sunak as a scapegoat. They are going to let him screw everything up that he can, because at this point he doesn't even need a shovel to dig himself into a hole. They're going to let him carry on. They're going to let him screw up. And he's going to get to a point where they say, okay, we're going to get rid of Sunak. We're going to replace him with this person. Please vote for us. Now, I don't know who that person is, because we have run out of options. He was literally last option, because we had Bojo, who I think he's a criminal. You know, the police charged him with something to do with lockdown parties. I don't know if that makes him a criminal or not. If it does, it means he cannot be Prime Minister. It's actually like illegal for a criminal to be Prime Minister. So that's fun. So, and after him, was it Liz Truss who lasted like 3 days? Something stupid like that. And then after her, it was Sunak. So he's like bottom of the barrel. He's the last option, and he's screwing it up. But then again, he is a multi-millionaire. His wife is one of the richest people in the world. She's richer than the Queen was. So that he lives in a different world, let's face it. But, dude, I think he's going to be a scapegoat. Come the next election, which is due some point this year, we will see. And I may be posting a video saying, told you so, and I might do the little dance. If you've seen Will and Grace, you know what that dance is. But this is just so funny. So far this week, and it is only Thursday, Rishi Sunak has bet on the lives of refugees. He has refused to apologise to a grieving mother that he is upset. He has lost one of their Tory donors. And he has fucked up his own NHS dentistry campaign by going to an NHS dentist that is no longer taking on NHS patients. So funny. Normally Sunak makes me angry, but this is just fucking comical. It's a joke. The UK government is a fucking joke. So after all that swearing and giggling at Rishi Sunak. Thank you for tuning in. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, share, etc. Come find me all over the social medias. I've recently started a Facebook page where we can carry on conversations, as well as the conversations in the comments here. And I think that's it. I'll see you in the next one anyway. Let's see if Sunak is the scapegoat. And also let's see if he manages to fuck up Friday as well. See you in the next one. Bye.